Hi, Ben from Freemius here. Today, I'm going to show you how to take any free WordPress plugin and turn it into a freemium plugin in less than 10 minutes using Freemius. This way, you can start leveraging our platform to monetize your plugin really quickly and easily. Let's plug in. First of all, if you are new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with all the latest advice and best practices for selling your WordPress plugins or themes. The plugin I'll use for this tutorial is the famous Hello Dolly plugin, which simply displays a random line from Louis Armstrong's song Hello Dolly every time you refresh the WordPress admin dashboard. This will be our free plugin, and I'm going to show you how to make it freemium with the Freemius WordPress SDK. Since my focus in this tutorial is on monetizing your product and not on creating features, I'll use a customized version of the plugin that adds a menu item to allow users to choose additional songs by Louis Armstrong and also shows the name of the song next to the line. These extra lyrics will be the paid features. First, let's add the plugin on Freemius and configure its plans. Log into the Freemius Developer Dashboard and click on Add Plugin. Make sure that the radio button is set on plugin and give it a title. We'll make sure to use hello-dolly for the plugin's slug, exactly matching the slug from wordpress.org. You can choose a custom icon for it if you want. Click on Create New to confirm. Before we start the SDK integration, let's define our plans. Go to Plans. As you can see, a free plan is automatically created when adding a new plugin. Now, let's configure the first paid plan by going back to Plans and clicking Add Plan. We will name it Summertime, give it a title, and click Create New. Now, we can set a description, and then our monthly, annual, or lifetime prices. In this case, we'll only set annual and lifetime. We can set bulk pricing for cases of multi-site license purchases for developers, agencies, etc. For now, we will only set single-site prices. Oh, and you can also set prices in other currencies like Euro and British Pounds. Next up is providing support. Paying users expect technical support from us, so we will enable it and add a support email where they can reach us. There are other channels of support that you can set up as well. Now, we need to decide whether the paid feature of this plan get locked when the plan's license expires, or to keep the features functional and only disable the updates and support for the plugin. The next step is to add the plan's features list. You can add all the free features to this paid plan by ticking the Include All Free Features checkbox. Then, create a new feature by typing its title and clicking the plus icon. You can add its value and description if you like. Now I'm going to create two more plans, each with added Armstrong song lyrics as features. After we have all of our plans in place, the next step is integrating the SDK by clicking on the SDK integration section and following the instructions. First, download the WordPress SDK from GitHub, rename it to Freemius, and copy it to the plugin's main folder. Now, we need to tell the SDK the location of the plugin's main settings page. In our case, we have a top-level menu which we customly added, and the menu slug is also Hello Dolly, so we will configure it accordingly. Now, we are simply going to copy the auto-generated integration snippet right into the plugin's main file and save it. go back to the WordPress admin dashboard and click on your plugin's name to verify that Freemius is working correctly. You will notice that the setting page is overridden by the SDK, prompting the admin to activate the plugin with a license key. This is because the integration snippet hints to the SDK that it's the paid version of the plugin. Let's go to the plugin's code and adjust the isPremium flag from true to false to emulate as if we are running the free version of the plugin and save the file. Now, if we refresh the page on the WordPress dashboard, you'll notice that instead of the license activation prompt, Freemius is asking the user to opt into data sharing. This is a very important feature that Freemius adds to your product, usage tracking and analytics. With the collected data, you'll be able to know who your users are, what sites your plugin is installed on, and other useful metrics. This page will be shown to the user only once per plugin, so if they update it in the future, this opt-in will not be displayed again. The user also has the option to skip the opt-in so that no data will be sent to our servers. We'll approve the connection and activate the plugin. You can see that all of the paid features remain, even though we are emulating the free plugin version. To finalize the process, we need to tell Freemius which blocks of code are associated with the paid plugin version. We'll open the SDK licensing document, copy the can use premium code premium only method, and paste it onto our plugin's code to wrap the paid feature with a special condition that tells the SDK that these features are only enabled for license holders. It also gives a hint to the deployment process, which we'll get to soon, that the paid logic needs to be stripped from the free version generated by Freemius. You can find the complete list of the license-related methods available via the SDK in our documentation center. Now, we'll refresh the admin dashboard page, and you'll see that all the songs except Hello Dolly have disappeared as expected, since we're currently using the free plan and codebase. To see what songs we get when we upgrade, let's go to the upgrade page and choose the Lifetime Wonderful World plan. As you can see, the checkout happens directly inside the WordPress admin dashboard, and it's completely secure and PCI compliant. Now, we'll click the pre-filled credit card link, which is only available in sandbox mode, to automatically pre-fill the checkout with a testing credit card and billing information to complete the purchase. You can see that the plan was changed to Wonderful World and that the user is presented with an admin notice to download the premium version of the plugin. When we open the settings page, we see that even though the plan is upgraded, only Hello Dolly is shown. That's because we previously edited the isPremium flag to false to emulate the free codebase. Let's change it back to true to see how the settings page will look like when running the paid version. As you can see, after refreshing the page, all the songs are back since we are now a paying customer and running the paid plugin version. But there's a small problem. Dream a Little Dream is there, even though it should only be available when buying the Little Dream plan. To fix this, we need to explicitly tell the SDK which songs belong to which plans. If we go back to the licensing document and look at the isPlan method, we'll see that it checks if the user is on a specified plan. And this is exactly what we need. Let's apply it in the plugin. Go back to the WordPress admin dashboard, click the plugin main menu item, and see that Dream a Little Dream is no longer available. Almost done. To keep the plugin compliant with the WordPress.org guidelines, we cannot upload it as is to the .org repository. It has premium code in it, and that's not allowed. So, what we'll have to do is deploy the plugin through Freemius first. Compress the plugin's folder, then go to the developer dashboard, navigate to the deployment section, and then click the add new version button. Select the zip file and upload it. The deployment of the plugin onto Freemius kills two birds with one stone. The SDK will serve premium releases as software updates to active license holders via WordPress native updates mechanism directly in the WordPress admin dashboard. Freemius will automatically generate a free version of the plugin stripped of the paid features. This is the version you need to download and push to the WordPress.org repository. If we take a look at the code of the free version, we can see that none of the paid lyrics exist there. That's it! You're now ready to start monetizing your WordPress plugins or themes with Freemius. If you like this tutorial, you can get notified of newly released videos by subscribing to our YouTube channel, where we share the latest advice and best practices for selling your WordPress products. See you next time!